for hundreds of beekeepers across the southeast, the emergence of the parasitic varroasis mite could signal their death knell. The millimetre-wide mite feeds off bees within the honeycomb, first attacking the larva and then the adult bees. It can be several years before it's detected, and by then the effects on bee colonies can be dramatic. In severe infestations, entire colonies can be wiped out altogether. The mite's been known on the continent since the early 1970s. It was thought the country's natural barrier, the Channel, would prevent it spreading here. But several weeks ago, it was found in Devon. Now it's been spotted in Farnham in Surrey. Beekeepers are now checking their beehives for signs of the mite. Many fear the British honey industry could be severely affected.
What would you actually be looking for the mite?
Well, at the moment, the mites would be either out on the backs or on the surfaces of the worker bee. The actual incubation of the mite is taking place underneath these cappings, and this is what makes it so difficult for the beekeeper to spot the disease.
So if we lose, say, 50% of our beekeepers in the country, then it means that English honey is going to be more scarce, and the price, of course, will go up accordingly. But it's going to devastate beekeeping as we've known it in the past.
There's no known cure for the mite, but beekeepers are being urged by the Ministry of Agriculture, Fisheries and Food not to transport bees and to use this leaflet in helping them to detect whether the bees are infested with the mites. This is Githa Hutton in Surrey for Thames News.